Did you catch last night's Oscars? The changes were very noticeable by most viewers, who observed the huge difference in how the Oscars were handled. Low-key compared to previous years, filled with red carpet glitz, fanfare, live entertainers, and comedian hosts, celebrity chefs preparing elegant dinners, and a slew of must-attend after-parties like Elton John's Vanity Fair. This year, the Oscars were more than being about awards and acknowledgements, and more about speaking out towards the pandemic and social justice. The 93rd Academy Awards, otherwise known as the Oscars, brought many expected and unexpected turns. The event took place again at the Dolby Theatre with separate locations at Union Stations in Los Angeles, UK, Paris, and Sydney, Australia, with none other than Borat himself, Sacha Baron Cohen, and his wife, actress Ilsa Fisher. This was a result of the COVID-19 restrictions across the world. Hi, I'm your host, Janette Burke. Welcome to another of Janette's TV and podcast, Hot Topics, our special new segment where I discuss topics that are all the rage. Today, I'm giving you my rendition of Sunday night's Oscars. But before I get into my commentary, I'd like to do a little housekeeping. Please remember to hit the bell to subscribe and like our YouTube channel and watch all our episodes where you can post your comments in the feed. We also invite you to share us with your family and friends. Support us on Patreon. No donation is too big or too small. And or purchase a Janette's TV and podcast quality t-shirt or sweatshirt with your choice of Janette's TV and podcast logo and tagline or inspirational saying made by me and one of my guests in a previous episode. You get to choose your color and your size. And payment includes shipping and handling, and all the items are conveniently delivered straight to your door. Please check the links in the description below for more details and consider supporting us in some way as we try and continue to bring you very good content, great topics, and great guests. Now back to my commentary on the Oscars. Much of the Oscars were filmed online, but in LA, some notable celebrities did walk the red carpet. These stars of color included Steven Yeun for lead actor in Minari, Riz Ahmed for best lead actor role in Sound of Metal, and Daniel Kaluuya for best supporting actor for Judas and the Black Messiah. Of course, extravagant designer outfits were still the norm in the Academy's dress code, which was mailed out to nominees and attendees alike ahead of time. Amanda Siegfried's bright red dress, Halle Berry's warm purple outfit, and Zendaya's stunning one-piece Versace yellow dress were just some of the more outstanding fashions that graced the red carpet in traditional Hollywood style. Color on the red carpet wasn't the only thing that changed for the Oscars. For the very first time, the Academy nominated not one, but two women for Best Director. Chloe Zahoya for Nomadland and Emerald Fennell for Promising Young Woman. And we saw an all-black producing team also nominated for the first time for Best Picture for Judas and the Black Messiah. The Academy also nominated their first Asian and Muslim lead actors in Steven Yeun and Riz Ahmed. It goes without saying that the Oscars are finally taking its first step to right the wrongs from previous Oscars, where majority of nominations were non-African Americans and other missing ethnics. A big surprise was some of the nominations and even winners were movies that were not even in theaters ever, but rather streamed on platforms like Netflix, Amazon, and Disney Plus. I guess you could say that might be expected in the confines of the pandemic, where movie theaters aren't always open. There are a lot of notable awards at the Oscars, but today I'm only going to focus on the winners of supporting roles lead roles and Best Picture due to time constraints. Of course, this isn't the Academy's fault, but COVID-19 did put restrictions on who were actually able to be in the theater. Lots of the winners were standing in front of a green screen wearing what they would usually wear at an Oscars type of event, but who knows if they were actually wearing only half of their outfits or what actually they would have on below their waist. Maybe a nice jacket with a pair of jeans? Who's to say? Regardless, the show did go on, and that's a good feat for them, that they were able to move forward despite the odd award presentation. Daniel Kaluuya took the award for Best Supporting Actor for his role in Judas and the Black Messiah. Daniel played Black Panther lead Fred Hampton. He stepped up to the stage and used his Oscar speech to acknowledge the character he played. The award was well deserved, and although he mentioned some very strange things about his parents and things like saying things about his parents having sex during the speech, and there was no doubt that he is a talented actor and he deserves this award, while his sister and mother watched him deliver that speech and kind of were like embarrassed, but it was cool to see. Adding yet another first, Yuh-JungYoun, who played Grandma from Minari, won Best Supporting Actress. Yuh-Jung is the first Korean actress to win the award. She used her speech to talk about watching the Oscars from home in South Korea and how surreal it was for her to actually be there in person. She played the grandma from an Asian family living in America, and she really deserves her award. It was really nice to see her incredible spirit and joy on screen. Like I said before, this Oscars was not a traditional one. You would have expected the winner from the Best Picture to be announced last, but this time it was announced before the announcement of Best Lead Actress and Actors. The winner for the Best Picture went to Nomadland. The movie stars Frances McDormand, a Van Welling woman who leaves her hometown of Empire, Nevada after her husband passes away and her town actually gets shut down because the factory shut down. So she has to start traveling around the United States in this van. The film is definitely a straightforward film, but adds the Oscar winner for Best Director, Chloe Zhao, and Lead Actress winner, Frances McDormand. Nomadland took a lot of awards home, and they were all well-deserved. Movies that talk about mental health and being free require attention to every scene, and Nomadland gave it that and a whole lot more. Finally, the last award for lead actor went to the oldest winner ever, Anthony Hopkins. The 83-year-old took home the award for his role in The Father, where, you guessed it, he played a father whose grip on reality is fading. He's probably dealing with dementia, but he refuses to allow a carer to look after him. Hopkins wasn't present to accept his award, but despite the victory, a lot of people favored the late Chadwick Boseman to win this award. Well, I guess we don't always get what we expect or we put our wagers on. The Oscars have slowly been dwindling in ratings and views, like many other award shows, despite their efforts to carry on. This year didn't help that much, since a lot of the celebrities were not in LA where the awards were being handed out. Watching the Oscars felt a bit disorganized, with there being no clear host, although I do think that Regina King did try to do a very good job. Half the people were not in attendance, and of course, the odd choice of presenting Best Picture earlier rather than later. Well, I'm happy to say the underdogs of a different color and gender won this year, and it was wonderful to see that. It didn't help the fact that there was a lack of movies in 2020 being made, and the Oscars felt a little bit stale and short of movies, but it did give the winners a little bit more time to give their acceptance speeches. Overall, if you missed last night's Oscars, you didn't really miss that much. While there were firsts and history makers, it doesn't change my opinion on the OK 93rd Academy Awards. If you were able to see it, I'd love you to share your thoughts. And I want to thank you for being with us today. I'm Janette Burke, your host, signing off. Please remember to like, comment, and share all our posts with your family and friends. You will find us on YouTube, Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram, Pinterest, Twitter, Vimeo, and so many more places, as well as hear Janette's TV podcast on our podcast stations on Apple, Spotify, iHeartRadio, Anchor, Google Podcasts, BuzzFeeds, and lots more. You name it, we're there. Hashtag Janette's TV and podcast. Until next time, continue to be fabulous and please stay safe.